Yes, good morning to all. Yes, please mute yourself. Pahul. Yes. So first we will go through the attendance. Yes, please switch on your cameras for the attendance so that we can proceed further. First is 11F. We have Avishi. Then is Surkhab. Then is from 11F, we have Push. Then is Farman. And Pahu. Okay. From other sections, from 11E, anyone from 11E? Kamaljeet. And from 11D, it's Harsh. Yes, any student whose attendance is not done? Okay, so today we will start the new topic also, as well as start the day with few programs. So first we will start with the first program based on the NumPy. So just note down the question. So this is the question that you have. Write a NumPy program to create a 3x3 matrix with values ranging from 2 to 10. Write a NumPy program to create the 3x3 matrix with values ranging from 2 to 10. Yes, one student is ready. Yes, Jabit, batao aap, how we will proceed?
X is equal to np dot arrange 2 comma 11, y is equal to np dot reshape in brackets x comma again brackets 3 comma 3 and then print y.
First, we need to create an array. So first, we need to create an array starting from 2 to 10, and then basically make a 3x3 matrix. So you see here, now we have 9 elements are there. Now we have to convert into a 3x3 matrix. यस यस ये एरर कैसे ये कौन सा एरर आ गया हमारे पास ऑन यस पुश
सर सिंटेक्स एरर एनपी इट शुड बी एनपी डॉट रीशेप
सो वी हैव टू मेंशन द पैकेज आल्सो क्लियर सो बाय दिस वे वी हैव First, we have created an array starting from 2 to 10 and then now converted into a 3x3 matrix. One more related question is there, that is how to reverse the elements of an array. To reverse the, like we created the same array and now how to reverse them. So this is the array that we have. Now, how we want to reverse that? This element should appear first, then this should be second, then this should be next, and so on. Yes, yes, push.
Sir, print x, then no, print x, then we use that slicing. Two colons, minus one comma two colons, and then minus one, and then we close the bracket.
Clear. So this is the way we can reverse the elements. Clear. Starting from the last comes the first, and so on. So like this, now there are so many questions are there that you can practice. Fine. So my humble request is please make a practice of these programs. Clear? Don't say that this NumPy is over. Clear? So we'll be discussing few questions on the daily basis. Clear? Just to ensure that we have a good practice of this NumPy programs. Okay. Yesterday we have discussed the practical programs. Clear? And then we will take few more programs which are may not be the part of the practical list. So the practice is very important from learning point of view. So let us move to the next topic, that is today we are going to start with this database concepts. Clear? So this is a new unit that we are going to start. You can have a look at the syllabus also, what we have covered and what we are left with. So today we are going to start with the database concepts. Before that, just have a look at the syllabus, that which topics we have covered and which topics we are left. So you can see here, so total we have 5 units with us. First we have worked on introduction to Python, and then we were working on data handling using NumPy. Clear? So now we are going to work on the major topic, that is the database concepts and SQL. So you can also look at the weightage. Clear? So it consists of this 20 marks in the final exam. So now, looking at the, what is the database concepts are there. So first you look at the definition of a database. What is a database? It is a collection of data or information that is organized so that it can be easily accessed, managed and updated. So we have to organize the data in such a way that we can easily access, we can manage it, we can update. So first of all, we have to populate a database. Clear? We have to fill the database. So that is the first is storing the information or inserting the information into the database, and then managing and updating that very information. So in database, the data is organized. The jo database hum study kar rahe hain, that data is basically organized into rows and columns. Clear? So in the database, the data is organized into rows and columns, means it is stored in the tabular form. Clear? And tables. And it is indexed to make it easier to find relevant information. Like we have index in the book, that is there to find the information in a faster way. Similarly, we have the concept of indexing in database also. That is, its prime aim is to have the access over the required information a bit fast. So it works like a container which contains the various objects like tables, queries, reports in a organized. So a database consists of tables, queries by which we ask questions to the database, and finally we have reports. So these are the different objects of the database. So real life mein hum kahan pe use karte hain, in real life where we use the database? Kisi ko idea hai? Yes, I request others to please switch on your cameras. Arjot Singh, Harman Singh, then Sukhjab Singh, then Pahul 11F, Harsh, Amar Pal, Sahil Preet and Kamal Ji. यस हाँ सुरखाब बताओ
सो बाय मेकिंग फ्रॉम लिस्ट लाइक फ्रॉम द रोल नंबर्स और इफ वी वांट टू मेक द मार्किंग द लिस्ट फॉर मार्क्स वी आल्सो यूज डेटाबेस ओवर देयर लाइक इन स्कूल्स
यस सो वी यूज डेटाबेस इन स्कूल्स एज अदर देन स्कूल्स वेयर वी यूज द डेटाबेस यस अविशी
So we use database in maintaining some records. It may be at any working place, in offices or banks, rather than schools.
Hmm. So we use database in banks also. Clear? So in different areas, we make use of the database. Yes, Japit.
It is used in hospitals for maintaining the records of patients.
Yes. So, you know, we have discussed the example of hospital, schools, offices, banks, a railway organization. So all the major organizations, they are using the, making use of the database. Clear? So this is, we should be aware where the databases are basically used. So we can briefly say that no big organization can survive without a proper database. Now the next is the next important question is, what is the need for a database? Why do we need database? What is the requirement for a database? So first point is to manage large chunks of data. So what is this? To manage large chunks of data. Anyone who will elaborate this point? Yes, Push.
Sir, it means that a database has the capacity to hold the large amount of data. So we can store data which is very, large, and other applications can't store it.
Yes, anyone else to manage large chunks of data? For this, we need a database. Anyone else who wants to contribute on this point? Yes, Abhishek.
So to maintain the large records?
Yes. So you know that we have to apply the different operations on the database. Jaise, if you go to a bank, clear? If we move to a bank, to agar hume uske andar, in a bank, a one bank contains thousands of and millions of customers with them. So it's very difficult to store their information manually or like in some other way. So for this, we need a database. So to store large chunk of information, and we have to also apply the different operations, like we have to update the data. So if we are not storing it in a database, how will we be able to access the information in a less time? Clear? वो customer हमें ये थोड़ी बोलेगा कि हमें 5 दिन में मेरा record update करके दे दो. They will be asking that what is the balance of my account is, tell me now. Clear? So for such operations, we need a database, that is to store and manage large chunks of data. So if the size of data increases into thousands of records, like we take the example of a bank also, to a school also. So in our school also, we have a huge strength. So it simply create a problem to manage. So database can manage large amount of data. So now to handle the big organizations, like you can see the big banks like State Bank and all the other banks, HDFC, ICIC Bank also, insurance companies also. So they have a huge customer base. To manage such a customer base, it's not possible to work without a database, because how to handle this large amount of customers? Then is the point number two is why we need database is accuracy. Anyone who will say something on this, what do you mean by this term accuracy, and why we need database to implement this point? And yes, Japit.
For example, अगर human beings जैसे humans करे तो वो इतना correct नहीं हो सकता, there are chances of mistakes, but database बहुत अच्छी तरह से इसको define किया होता है, अच्छी तरह से manage कर सकता है, तो accuracy बनी रहती है.
Now, yes, Avishi.
So the same answer, it can maintain accurate data rather than a human being.
So what is with regard to the accuracy is there, no? If we talk of a bank or any other organization, there are a lot of validation checks are there in the database. Like what are the validation checks are there? कि जैसे आप लोगों ने बैंक में सेविंग अकाउंट खुलवाया, ठीक है, तो अगर आपके अकाउंट में 10,000 है तो आप 10,000 रुपए तक आप विड्रॉल करा सकते हो. ये नहीं है कि आपने 10,000 जमा कराया है और आप 15,000 निकलवा के आगे पास, ठीक है, if we are discussing the saving account. So there are a lot of validation checks are made so that our database remains in a accurate state. Clear? So it has a lot of examples that we can give from the real life. Clear? Where we try to maintain the accuracy. Clear? So that our database is in a accurate state. The next point is ease of updating the data. Yes. How we have ease of updating the data with regard to a database? Yes, only few students are participating in the class. And we have a lot of students, Tanish, Amarpal, Sahil Preet, Harsh, Harman Singh, हाँ जी यस श्री आप बताओ.
Sir, in database, the data is arranged between various rows and columns due to which it is easily accessible.
Yes. So that is the one of the important point is that is the ease of updating is if we go to a bank or any big organizations. So if we have to now update any of the record. So now database, you can say with the help of data, we can access any of the customer record in a fraction of second by entering the customer ID or his account number. So from such details, we can update his data at the earliest. Clear? Like you go to a bank and you know, whenever we are depositing the money, we are withdrawing the money. So in that case, we have to, now the bank people have to update the database. So we can easily do this operation, updation with the help of a database. Then the next point is security of data. So we can properly maintain the security of the database with the help of applying different username and passwords and also privileges to restrict access. Like if we go to a bank, aap kisi bhi organization mein jaate ho, to jitne bhi user us organization mein kaam karte hain, they are not given with the same sort of rights. Each person is given the different rights according to his work, according to his whatever the duty is assigned to that persons. We basically give the rights to each user according to the access he needs. Iska fayda kya hai hamein? Can someone elaborate on this point? Why we give these the different rights to different users? हाँ जी यस श्रीया
सर इससे सिर्फ एक स्पेसिफिक पीपल ही डाटा को एक्सेस कर सकते हैं और उसमें चेंजेस कर सकते हैं और डाटा लीक नहीं हो सकती इसके
जैसे जैसे आप देखो अगर अगर आप बैंक के अंदर नो देर आर द पीपल हु आर वर्किंग ऑन द एचआर साइड अब एचआर साइड जो है दैट इज कीपिंग ट्रैक ऑफ योर लीव्स कीपिंग ट्रैक ऑफ योर नो सैलरी एंड सो ऑन तो ऐसे आप बैंक के अंदर जाके तो अगर हम किसी को एक्सेस नहीं प्रॉपरली देंगे तो आप किसी की भी सैलरी चेक कर लोगे क्लियर किसकी सैलरी कितनी है क्लियर एंड इसको कितनी इंक्रीमेंट लगी है सो नो दी वाइटल इंफॉर्मेशन कैन बी इजीली एक्सेस्ड सो टू अवॉइड दिस सॉर्ट ऑफ ब्रीचेस वी बेसिकली इंप्लीमेंट द कंसेप्ट ऑफ द प्रिविलेजेस टू रिस्ट्रिक्ट द एक्सेस ऑफ डिफरेंट यूजर्स एंड द लास्ट पॉइंट इज डाटा इंटीग्रिटी In database, we can assure of accuracy and consistency of data due to built-in integrity checks and access controls. So we have applied different integrity checks that we will discuss in detail in the upcoming lectures, and also access control. Abhi access control humne pichle jo is point mein bhi padha tha access control. Basically, their aim is to have accuracy as well as consistency of the data. Consistency of the database means that every time we get the result, it should be always the correct data should be there. ठीक है जैसे आप अपना अकाउंट का बैलेंस चेक करते हो तो ये तो नहीं कि सुबह चेक किया तो कुछ और आ रहा है दोपहर को किया कुछ और आ रहा है और शाम को किया कुछ और आ रहा है क्लियर सो वी नीड द कंसिस्टेंसी इन द डेटाबेस ऑल्सो दैट एवरी टाइम वी गेट द करेक्ट रिजल्ट फ्रॉम द डेटाबेस सो दीज आर द बेसिक points that highlights the need for database. So the next is the DBMS. So what is a DBMS? This is basically a software. Clear? So a DBMS refers to the software that is responsible for storing, maintaining, and utilizing the database. So DBMS, जैसे हम हमारे syllabus में क्या है MySQL है, that is a DBMS. So with the help of which, what we can do, we can store the data, we can insert the data, update the data, delete the data, clear? And we can apply different operations on our database, clear? In a proper way and in a efficient way. The second point is that the database along with DBMS software is called a database system. So the combination of database plus the DBMS software is known as database system. We have different examples of the DBMS softwares like Oracle is there, Microsoft SQL Server is there, Microsoft Access is there, Paradox is there, DB2 is there, and MySQL is there. So these are the DBMS softwares of different organizations, like Oracle is there, Microsoft is there, IBM is there. Clear? And the last point is that MySQL is open source and freeware DBMS. That means that you don't need a license to use MySQL. It is freely available, and you can download this MySQL and you can make use of this software. Now, there are few advantages also of the database system. The first point is that database reduces the redundancy. Redundancy is basically the duplicacy that we have. So it removes duplication of data because data are kept at one place and all the application refers to the centrally maintained database. Now, what we try to do that is database helps in reducing the redundancy. Clear? That if we are keeping the multiple records of one person, जैसे एक पर्सन के हमने मल्टीपल रिकॉर्ड रखे हुए हैं, सो इफ यू आर कीपिंग द मल्टीपल रिकॉर्ड ऑफ ए वन पर्सन, तो अगर उसने एक रिकॉर्ड में चेंज करवा लिया तो दूसरे रिकॉर्ड में जो है दैट इज इट रिमेंस अनअपडेटेड. क्लियर? जैसे किसी स्टूडेंट ने अगर अपना एड्रेस चेंज करवा लिया, नाउ लेट्स से ही शिफ्टेड फ्रॉम द स्टूडेंट ही शिफ्टेड फ्रॉम लेट्स से दसुआ टू मुकेरिया, तो अगर हमारे पास मल्टीपल रिकॉर्ड्स हैं, सो व्हाट विल हैपन, वी विल फेस द डिफिकल्टी ऑफ डुप्लीकेशन. So this can be better managed with the help of a database. Similarly, next point is database controls inconsistency. Now, this is a very important point. Inconsistency. कोई बता सकता है inconsistency होती क्या है basically? How we define inconsistency? And yes, Japit.
So when a smooth flow of information is not maintained, that is called inconsistency.
Can you give any example of inconsistency?
Yes, sir. So for example, in database, if we have a mother table and we have a primary key table and the other one foreign key table. So agar hum a foreign key table mein koi aisi row add karenge jiski value primary key mein hai nahi, to fir wo inconsistent cheez ho jayegi.
Other than this, give some simple example from the real world. Don't. I am not expecting that example should be from database itself. I am just focusing on the word inconsistency. Any example of inconsistency in real world? It may be from database. It may be from any other domain. Yes. Other than Japit, someone else wants to define on inconsistency. Inconsistency ka opposite hai consistency. ठीक है, जैसे हमारी क्लास हो रही है, नाउ वी हैव ए क्लास एट 9 o'clock ऑन डेली बेसिस, फ्यू पीपल आर कमिंग इनटू द क्लास रेगुलरली एंड फ्यू पीपल आर कमिंग, जैसे आज आ गए, फिर वेंसडे को आ गए, फिर सैटरडे को आ गए, फिर नेक्स्ट वीक में एक बार आ गए. सो दीज आर द टू डिफरेंट सिनेरियोज ऑफ कंसिस्टेंसी एंड इनकंसिस्टेंसी. इफ यू आर कमिंग टू द क्लास रेगुलरली, सो नो द स्टूडेंट इज कंसिस्टेंट इन द क्लास. Then we can look at the performance also, performance of a student from consistent point of view and inconsistent. Ek test mein achhe marks aage, dusre mein kharab aage, tisre mein fir achhe aage. So it means that the student is having a inconsistent report. So when we are not able to perform any action regularly, so now that falls under the category of inconsistency. So now coming back to the database, when two copies of the some data do not agree to each other, then it is called inconsistency. Clear? So, जैसे inconsistency की problem कहाँ पे आती है हमारे पास? जैसे हम transaction perform करते हैं, clear? So, whenever we perform a transaction, it has basically two parts. कोई transaction को define कर सकता है? What is a transaction is basically? Transactions from the real world. Yes, Shriya.
Sir, it refers to transferring money from one's account to another account.
जी?
Sir, it refers to transferring of money from one account to another account.
हाँ, transferring of money from one account to another. Yes, इसके अलावा कोई transaction की एक example है, any one example of transaction is. Yes, Jabir.
सर कोई भी ऐसा इवेंट जिसमें हम मनी एक्सचेंज कर रहे हैं फिर मनी की वैल्यू वाली कोई चीज एक्सचेंज कर रहे हैं, जैसे अगर हम सिंपली बुक की जैसे हम बुक्स बाय करते हैं तो वो भी एक ट्रांजैक्शन होगी क्योंकि हम बुक्स ले रहे हैं और पैसे दे रहे हैं.
सो बेसिकली व्हाट आई वांट टू हाईलाइट दैट व्हेनेवर वी परफॉर्म अ ट्रांजैक्शन इट हैज बेसिकली टू एस्पेक्ट्स. वन इज दैट इफ लाइक द एग्जांपल इज गिवन बाय जब दिस वी गो टू अ शॉपकीपर फॉर बाइंग अ बुक. So we have to pay the money and then he will give back the book to us. So if let's say if only one part is done, let's say I have paid the money but he's not giving me the book, or he has given me the book and I am not giving back the money. Clear? So then that the transaction is partial basically. No, it is not complete. It is only complete when both the aspects is done. Clear? When we have taken away the book also and he has taken away the money also. Like we perform the online transactions, clear? So sometimes what happens, so due to some error, clear, sometimes the transaction is not done properly, clear? So what is ensured in consistency, this feature ensures that either the transaction is complete or the transaction is to the previous status. It is not done partially, it is done completely. So if your transaction is done completely, it is called the database is in consistent state. Clear? So we can elaborate this point more also. Then is the third point is the database facilitates sharing of data. So now we are all familiar with this point is that sharing of data is done like you deposit your money in maybe in Dasua branch and later on you can go to Mukeria and you go to Thankot, you go to Jalandhar and you access your account and you get the updated information over there. So this is done with the help of the sharing of information is done. So that's a very important feature and advantage. Then is database ensures security. So we have already focused a lot on this, that the data is protected against accidental and इंटेंशनल. बोथ आर डिफरेंट. एक्सीडेंटल में क्या है कि आपकी इंटेंशन ऐसी नहीं है, आपसे गलती से डाटा डिलीट हो गया. क्लियर? और इंटेंशनल ये है कि जैसे हैकर ने आके आपका डाटा को आपके अकाउंट को एक्सेस करके उसमें से कोई ट्रांजेक्शन परफॉर्म कर. सो बेसिकली जो डाटा बेस है इट इंश्योर्स दी एक्सीडेंटल एज वेल एज इंटेंशनल एक्सेस एंड मोडिफिकेशन टू दी डाटा. एंड दी लास्ट पॉइंट हियर इज that the database maintains integrity. So database maintains integrity means that it enforces certain integrity rules. Like you can see here, if you enter a date like this, agar aap aisi date enter karte ho, the system will not accept this date because you know the month format is only up to 12. Clear? Month ki value kya hai? Maximum 12 ho sakti hai. So let's say this 31 represents the day, but this 31 is will not be accepted because we cannot have a value 31 against the month. So this is one of the example. There are so many rules and checks are applied to maintain the integrity of the data. Okay, so these are the few basic points that we have gone through with regard to the concepts of database. ठीक है. So database is no organization basically can survive without the database. Any question you have regarding the database or you want to ask any question? Clear? So now please go through these points also and verify these points from the book. ये नहीं है कि आपने PPT से ही पढ़ना है ना. PPT is basically used for teaching purposes. But you have the book also. Clear? You have NCERT book also, and you can refer to the Sumita Arora book also. And please thoroughly read these points. Clear? And if you have any doubt, you can ask. Okay. So thank you very much. And we'll meet now next tomorrow. Thank you.